Actors in Television, Mr. Henry Morgan.
May I introduce a very young and charming old friend, Gypsy Rose Lee.
And now the man who was too short-sighted to publish any of my books, Bennett Cerf.
Is the very last word in water pollution, calipigian damsels, and panel moderating, John Charles Degley.
Well, Miss Lee and Mr. Morgan, welcome.
Thank you.
You've picked a very good night to come, because our tricks are, I think, a little more interesting tonight than on most nights. So brace yourselves for a half hour, which will, I trust, give you some fun, even though you don't guess anything. Bennett, I didn't mean that for you. Arlene, you're going to California. Arlene's going to go to Palm Springs right after the program, and I can't get her to take me even as cargo, which I wish we could do.
Just ask me.
Yeah, I will do that. I will do that. We'll also have a famous mystery guest before the panel a little bit later in the program, but right now, let's meet our first contestant. Will you enter and sign in, please? Mr. X.
That's fine. Thank you very much, Mr. X. And we'll also tell you something, panel. We're not going to tell you anything about where Mr. X is from, because we feel this also might give you some information. But I would like to present our panel, Mr. X. Now, will you join me over here, please, sir? And we'll let the audience in the theater and the audience at home know exactly what your name is and what your line is. All right. As I told you, Gypsy and Henry, you know, we're going to play some tricks tonight. Arlene and Bennett are used to it. But we will give you this much information. Mr. X is self-employed and he deals in a service. And we'll begin things with, Bennett, sir.
Mr. X, you have an air about you that would indicate to me that you come from, that you're either French or English. Is that correct?
Which one?
Oh, was it one of the two?
Yes.
I'll choose English, having heard you.
Yes.
Are you from England?
I am.
Do you perform your service in England?
I do.
Has your service got anything to do with the world of fashion?
It has.
Now, I guess that this, there's a girl that's just come over here called, he was a very famous model. Have you ever used the services of Twiggy in the work that you do?
I have.
Were you a designer of clothes?
No.
So, one down, nine to go, Arlene. Very good, though, Bennett.
However, do you represent men's fashions in England?
No.
No?
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Morgan.
Do you have anything at all to do with fashion?
Actually, Henry, you put your thumb on it. What we have agreed is that there is a relationship between our guest and the fashion world. Now, what you have to determine is what this relationship is.
Well, we, That sounded like a reprimand, and I wish you would do that. I have a very bad cold.
No, it isn't meant. All I'm trying to
and
do is
I don't
is
feel
to...
well at all, and I should
you
be
got a cold?
Very gently.
Have you got a cold?
I have pneumonia and a cold.
Oh, you have pneumonia and a cold. Well, Arlene, have a good trip if you make it. Now, the only thing I'm trying to suggest to you is that we have not said specifically that in the narrow confines of one description here that our guest necessarily spends all of his time. We have agreed that there is a relationship to the fashion field.
You know what he meant?
All right. Mr. X, do you perform a service, a unique service that is connected with the fashion field?
I like to think it's fairly unique, but it's a service.
Yes. Does it have to do in any way with graphic reproductions?
No.
Three down and seven to go. Miss Lee.
What does that mean, Henry?
Picture.
I see. Do you have anything to do with handling fabrics?
No.
Four down and six to go, Mr. Cerf.
Mr. Rex, by eliminating graphic reproductions, you are eliminating the entire world of photography, is that correct?
I am.
Do you come into any contact with the world that writes about fashion?
Yes, I do.
Comes into any contact with. Yes, we
very much so.
We've eliminated designing. We've eliminated being the man who runs one of these famous dress places, have we not?
Mm-hmm. Basically. Mm-hmm.
Do you ever have anything to do with these fashion shows that are put on for the hope mourned, as we say?
Yes, I do.
Oh, golly. You don't own the place. You don't. Are you a model yourself?
No! Five, John, five to go, Miss Francis.
But you do have something to do with putting on fashion shows.
Has
that
a relationship to them and to the fashion of an operation. I
do you represent a fashion house in some way?
Occasionally, yes.
Are
on
you
occasion.
An agent provocateur? I mean, do you come to this country? Are you here specifically for some particular fashions that are being shown here? Is that why?
Right now?
You might say I design a fashion and I do come here to develop it. Yes, you might say that.
I see. You have nothing to do with Carnaby Street?
I sometimes wear their clothes, but I have nothing to do with it. No.
All right, I gotta know.
That's right. That's six down and four. I'm going to give you one more minute because you're sticking too close to one area.
Mr. X, do you have anything to do with hair?
Yeah.
Oh, it's Sassoon.
Yeah, that's right. That was fun. But you see, Henry, now why I was saying a relationship to... I was trying to get you away just from fabrics and designs on fabrics, because Vidal Sassoon is certainly very much connected with the fashion. In fact, with Mary Quant, who is with us, you very often work directly with her in the presentation of new styles, don't you?
Well, we started pretty much at the same time, 10, 12 years ago, and we've worked together ever since.
So that when she comes here to do a fashion show, you'll come and...
I think she's in next week, actually.
How would you... must forgive me. I know very little about hairstyles. But yours is unique. How do you describe it? Geometric? How is it described? Not necessarily the way you describe it.
As you describe it.
Geometric?
What does that mean?
Well, we use the angles, lines and bone structures of people's faces, and we cut accordingly to broaden the... cheekbones and do something with the eyes.
What do you think of that close-cropped fashion brought in by Mia Farrow and her crowd?
She did a very good job, because it's very rarely that somebody outside fashion brings in a fashion that sticks. But then, actually, Jean Seberg did the same thing with the same line about 6-7 years ago.
Do you think we could do anything with Bennett's hair, given enough time?
We could contemplate, you know.
But Mr. Sassoon has, three shops in London?
Yes.
One
here.
He has a shop here, too?
And one in Washington, D.C., so that two-thirds, no, I guess two-fifths American now, at least in terms of your operations, right?
Actually, I came here this time not particularly to work, but to marry an American girl.
He married Beverly Dana last month?
Beverly Adams.
I'm sorry, and this last month?
That's right.
Did it all start with a haircut, Mr. Sassoon?
Well, truly it did. She came into the salon. She was making a picture in London and came in for a haircut. And I had a system in London where any pretty girls that came into town, I had to be told, you see.
Very good system.
Yeah, I hope you stop that now.
It stopped.
If that doesn't get you in some trouble in the years to come, I'll be a lot surprised. Well, may we congratulate, albeit a bit late, congratulate you and wish you much happiness and a long life and many issues.
Thank you indeed.
Nice day.